Attention Northeast Park Hill residents. This is a community notification of a new sexually violent predator in your area. Please stay tuned to the following short program for more information.
Hi, I'm Technician Ron Hackett with the Denver Police Department. The Sex Offender Registration and Compliance Unit at DPD is responsible for the registration, monitoring, and tracking of all registered sex offenders and sexually violent predators who live in the city and county of Denver. Here's a brief history of sex offender legislation in Colorado. Our state laws trickle down from federal government mandates. In 1994, we had the Jacob Wetterling Act, which mandated that states would establish a sex offender list. Megan's Law of 1996 said that the public would have access to those sex offender registration lists. The Pam Lichner Act of 1996 stated that some offenders might have to have lifetime registrations. And the Adam Walsh Act of 2006 unified sex offender laws across the country. In Colorado, the legislature has determined that sexually violent predators, by definition, pose a higher risk to the community at large, and therefore mandated that upon their release from the Department of Corrections, the community must be notified. Sex offender notification in Colorado happens in two ways. The first is passive and ongoing through the sex offender registration process, which is a list maintained by local police departments. The second way is active, via community notification for those offenders determined to be sexually violent predators by the courts or by the parole board. Most sex offenders in Colorado are supervised by the criminal justice system in our communities. Most sex offenders engage in crossover behavior, which means they may have been arrested for one type of crime, but be apt to commit another. Many sex offenders have no criminal history at all prior to their arrest. There is no typical sex offender, but all tend to be deceptive, manipulative, and secretive. 80 to 93% of sex offenses are committed by someone known to the victim. Sexual deviancy begins in mid to late adolescence. Sex offenses are not impulsive. They are usually carefully planned, and most sex offenders are male. The community has a vested interest in helping offenders to be successfully managed in the community. Sex offenders have the same need for housing and employment as any other citizen. Any citizen who uses sex offender information to harass, threaten, or intimidate an offender will be subject to criminal prosecution. There are approximately 16,500 registered sex offenders in the state of Colorado. About 65% of convicted sex offenders are placed in the community on probation. The remainder are in the Department of Corrections or Community Corrections. Offenders may be caught for one type of offense, but be at a high risk to commit another type. Crime of conviction is only one indicator of risk. A sexually violent predator must register with the Denver Police Department Sex Offender Registration Unit every 3 months for the rest of their life. The offender's residence must be verified quarterly by the Denver Police Department. The full sex offender registration list is available by calling the Denver Police Department Identification Bureau at 720-913-6756. Convicted felons and those with multiple convictions are posted online at denvergov.org/police. Remember, sexually violent predators do not represent all dangerous sex offenders. The community notification process and sex offender registration are not a complete deterrent to sexual assault. Now, here's a look at the newest sexually violent predator living in Denver.
Here's an overview of the registered sex offenders currently living in Denver. There are 2,533 total living within city limits. In Denver Police District 2, there are 382. Precinct 221 has 111 registered sex offenders. Of those, 77 have felony convictions and 34 have misdemeanor convictions. Charles Joseph Stout is a sexually violent predator currently living in Denver. He's 51 years old and was born on June 4, 1971. He's a white male, 5 feet 10 inches tall, 178 pounds, with brown hair and blue eyes. He's currently living at 3506 Hudson Street in the Northeast Park Hill neighborhood of Denver. Schools located within 1 mile of this offender include Stedman Elementary at 2940 Dexter Street, McAuliffe International School at 2540 Holly Street, Hallett Academy at 2950 Jasmine Street, Smith Elementary at 3590 Jasmine Street. Parks located within 1 mile of this offender include Colorado Boulevard Park, Skyland Park, City of Axum Park, Martin Luther King Jr. Park, Boyd Park, Fairfax Park. Recreation centers located within 1 mile of this offender include Martin Luther King Jr. Rec Center at 3880 Newport Street, Hiawatha Davis Jr. Rec Center at 3334 Holly Street. Bus routes located within 1 mile of this offender include Route 34, 36th Avenue and Holly Street, 35th Avenue and Glencoe Street, 35th Avenue and Holly Street. A brief history of charges against this offender. Sexual assault on a child, position of trust, victim under 15. He's currently on parole and registered with the Denver Police Department on April 18, 2022 to 3506 Hudson Street in the Northeast Park Hill neighborhood of Denver. Past charges against this offender include sexual assault on a child. Charles Joseph Stout has been determined a sexually violent predator after meeting the following criteria. Criteria 1, age 18 or older on the date of the offense, or under 18 and tried as an adult. The offender was age 30 at the time of the offense. Criteria 2, the crime must have been committed on or after July 1, 1997 and convicted on or after July 1, 1999. Crimes include sexual assault, felony unlawful sexual contact, sexual assault on a child, sexual assault on a child by a person in a position of trust. The offender was convicted on February 8, 2002 for sexual assault on a child, position of trust, victim under 15. Criteria 3, the relationship to the victim was one of the following. Victim was a stranger to the offender, or the offender established or promoted a relationship with the victim primarily for the purpose of sexual victimization. The victim was an 11-year-old male. The offender was known to the victim and was the victim's stepfather. Criteria 4, positive results or the passing of a risk assessment instrument administered by probation parole staff and a qualified treatment evaluator. Positive results include an assessment for the presence of a mental abnormality, a level of denial regarding the offense, treatment appropriateness and motivation, presence of sexual deviant interests. The offender was evaluated by the Fremont County Courts with positive results, determining him to be a sexually violent predator. We'll be right back.